Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from wherever you're watching this channel, depending on your time zone. Now this week, William Ruto and his deputy together, Gachagua, are in Rift Valley region. And not the entire Rift Valley, they are concentrating largely on North Rift and South Rift. That means largely the Kalenjin nation. That's where he has pitched his camp, his tent. That's where he's pushing for his political agenda. Now when you see him launching some projects here and there, he is pushing for his political agenda. I don't know what about the service to the people, if really he's doing so. But above all, we have seen William Ruto facing rejection. Yesterday he was in Bomet. Yesterday he was in Kericho County. And we shared the video here. It was disgusting because people heckled him. They booed him. They rejected the governor in his presence. He attempted to, you know, calm the people, but they never listened to him. They rejected a UDA governor in his presence. They refused to listen to his advice or appeal to the people so that they can allow him to address them. It was heckling and noisy. That was Kericho. Today, Ruto and Gachagua are in Bomet County. And the same is repeating. The governor was handed over a microphone to address the people, but it was total heckling. They booed at the governor, and as if it was not enough, Ruto attempted to silence the people. When he took over the microphone, tried to talk to the people, no one was willing to listen to him. Hata yeye walimchanganya hapo, wakapiga kelele. And when the governor attempted for the second time to address the people, it was a no-go zone. The situation was unwelcoming for William Ruto, the governor, Gachagua, and UDA team in Bomet County.
Our deputy president, Mkuwe ni watu wa kusoma barua ikiwa ndani ya bahasha. Kama kuna mtu hajafanya kazi, mwimngojee siku ya uchaguzi, mtamalizana na yeye. Lakini kwa sasa, tuko na mkutano, kama naongea. Asante rais. Ama ito haikina fasi ni rais ataache mwenda. Angoje yu, umesa umeruta si yu.
Now, besides this, there was a lot of disruption in Ruto's event, whereby there have been allegations that someone walked into that rally with a Maasai sword, and the police had a problem getting that sword from the victim. So it was also another drama, disruption, in the presence of William Samuel Ruto. So it has been a run down and up between the police and the residents in Bungoma. And this is how the situation was on the ground. I'm gonna go to the hospital. Now, the question is very simple here. Why is it that there is a lot of disruption, heckling, and booing in William Ruto's own organized events in Rift Valley? His home, his region, where he's coming from, the people who speak same language with him, why is it that they are making noise? They are throwing their hands in air. They don't want to listen to him. They are blocking UDA elected leaders. When we know that this one is a UDA stronghold. This is the origin of UDA. These are the owners of UDA party. But they are rejecting leaders elected on the same party. Why so? We want to look deep into that. But just a quick request for those who are watching and you have not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing. To our internet subscribers, Samasa, thank you so much. And again, to all our viewers, please give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much, and back to this discussion. Now, definitely, with this kind of behavior, the character we are seeing in Ruto's event, from Kericho, you come to Bomet, then it tells you that indeed, presidency is slowly lacking command to the respect it deserves. People will start seeing Ruto as a mere ordinary person. But there is an office, an institution, presidency. This is an office that needs to command respect. It is an office that needs to bring and unite all Kenyans together. Presidency. But it's slowly lacking command to the respect it deserves. And the obvious reasons are there. Why is Governor Hillary Banchok being rejected in the presence of Ruto? In terms of service delivery, he is copying what Ruto is doing up here. And he takes down the trickle-down effect in the county. When Ruto is lying on the national politics, the governor is lying down here. When Ruto is launching zero hot air projects, that is what the governor is doing in reciprocate. So there is trickle-down effect of UDA behavior from top coming down. And because of that, the people of Bomet are feeling that the governor has shortchanged them in terms of service delivery. He is not working for the people. But he's working for himself. And because he's not delivering services to the people, people are rejecting him in open air. So this tells you that leaders elected on UDA ticket, especially from Rift Valley, they thought that once they were elected, that is it. That once you get UDA ticket, that is it. But now, that is not enough. People need service on the ground. As long as you're not delivering, then you become an enemy of the people. So the issue of heckling, booing, and throwing hands in the air is going to be known. As long as this administration is not going to work for the people. So ile tabia yenye imefanyika pale kwa national executive pale, ndio Governor Hillary Banchok is taking to Bomet. But to his embarrassment, he's being rejected in front of William Ruto, the party leader of UDA, and the president. Imagine the kind of embarrassment in the presence of Ruto in a huge rally in your own region and home county where you come from. You are being rejected. This is a waiting protest, but to them, let them know that Hillary Banchok served and is serving second term. He will be going home. Maybe he will be looking for another seat. And that's the problem we are having with some governors. Some of them, when they know they are serving their second term in office, they relax and they don't deliver service to the people. So wapu ya lichukua tu ofisi wakati the first governor, second governor died. Joyce Laboso. So he took over and he ran one time na yako kwa ya pili. Hata enda ya tatu. Anaenda nyumbani. So to the people who met, he believed that he don't need your vote. And he's like, they are realizing that he's doing so knowing that he might not need their vote again. So, he is an unwelcomed leader in his own home. That's why they booed at him. They made too much noise to reject him. But again to William Ruto. Ruto attempted to silence the people, to appeal to them, to calm them, so that at least the governor can speak a word to them. To his shock, his own people, they speak same language. They refuse to listen even to William Ruto himself. And that's why I'm telling you that the presidency is missing. The president is losing its meaning. Because how dare you are the president, you've gone back home, you are trying to calm your own people, but they refuse to listen to you when they know that your office is the most high office in the land. You are in that office. You are that symbol of unity. When you speak, you should speak sense to the people and they should listen to you. Ruto has failed. This means people of Bomet have no respect for William Samoei Ruto. If they had respect for him, at least for a minute they would listen to William Ruto and they would calm, allow the governor to speak. But because they are angry, pissed off, they can't even listen to Ruto. Why? Because Ruto has failed from top there. And we are seeing the trickle-down effect hapa chini. Even if you go and check on the types of project that Ruto was going to launch, it's like this project has been serving people, or if not, he's launching hot air. So that means he's either launching someone else's projects, or he's coming to launch a project that is yet to kick off. Like what he did here in hapa Mago. Kwenda mululu, urudi paka, vocal. It was hot air up to date. Nothing happening on the ground. So, because the UDA administration has failed the people, it is very easy to reject them and even disrespect the president himself, because the president has failed to deliver to the people on his promises. Lower cost of living, then allow people to do their business, then don't kill jobs. Stop overtaxing Kenyans. That is what he promised, but he's doing total opposite. And now, this is the reaction to what exactly he is doing. So people are rejecting Ruto because they are realizing that the man they believed in, that in him that is going to solve their problem, has become the problem maker. Because of that, Ruto, na governor, na wale ambao, wanahusikana na yeye, wote wanakataliwa. That is the situation in Bomet. I don't know your views, but let us meet in the comment section to continue with this discussion. Thank you so much and see you in our next video.